This video is about the sample variance and the sample standard deviation. Variance and standard deviation is about the spread of the data. The more the data spread out, the larger the variance or the larger the standard deviation. Standard deviation is just the square root of the variance. I'm going to do an example here that will help you understand the concept of the variance and the standard deviation. So let's define the sample variance. Sample variance is the average, which is keyword, of the squared deviations, another keyword, from the sample mean. Mean is another important word, another key word. So the sample variance is represented as S squared, and that's equal to the sum of the squared deviations from I equals 1 to N divided by N, take away 1. Xi, you know, as the data points, and X bar, you know, as the mean. And so the deviation here is squared, the squared deviations from the mean. The big piece here is that a lot of students don't know how to calculate this piece right here. And that's where we're going to focus our attention by doing a table. But first we need some data points, and we're going to write a table with some columns to help us do this problem. And you notice that to do this column right here, we need the mean, which is not too hard to do. That's going to be X bar, which is equal to the sum of the data points divided by the number of data points. In this case, it's 5. So we add the top 20 divided by 5. That gives you 4. So the next step is to create this column right here for the deviations from the mean. It's not squared yet. It's just a deviation. So we're going to take 4, which is our data point, and we're going to subtract it from our mean, which is a 4 as well. When we subtract that, gives us a 0. So the next one is take your data point, which is 3, and subtract it from the mean, and that gives you negative 1. And let's do the rest. 7 take away 4 is 3. 5 take away 4 is 1. And 1 take away 4 is negative 3. Okay. So let's create another column. And now the deviations from the mean, let's square them. So we're going to take each answer that we got from the deviations from the sample mean, and we're going to square it. So the first one is 0 squared. That gives you 0. The next one is going to be negative 1 squared, which will give you 1. One key thing about doing this column is that all the answers are positive, because whatever deviation you get, it's going to be squared. Another key thing is, do these by mind. You know, write it out if you want to. Don't use a calculator, just do it. Negative 1 times negative 1 is going to be negative, times negative is positive. 1 times 1 is 1. So do that and you won't make a mistake there. Let's try the next one. 3 squared gives you 9. 1 squared equals 1. And the next one is negative 3 squared. Again, negative 3 times negative 3. Negative times negative is positive. 3 times 3 is 9. So, again, don't use your calculator. Use your mind. You'll be able to do it. And that gives you 9. Now, let's find the sums of the columns. Pretty straightforward. What's the sum of all the data points? That's going to give you 20. What's the sum of the deviations from the mean? Add all that up, it gives you 0. Most of the time I'll give you 0. It might be a little bit off if you have to round. And the next column is the squared deviations from the mean. And that's going to give you, in this case, 20. All right. So the question is, what is the sample variance? Well, that's of course the formula. And let's fill in those parts. The sum of the squared deviations from the mean, right? We calculated that already as 20. So let's put that in there. Divided by the data points. How many data points do we have? 5. Subtract 1 from the formula. So that gives you 20 divided by 4. And that gives you 5. So that is the sample variance. We also want to calculate the sample standard deviation. To do that, it's not a problem. That's going to be represented as S. And we take the square root of the variance, which is S squared. So S is the sample standard deviation, and S squared is the variance. And if we're doing this problem, that means if we want to find the sample standard deviation, we're going to have to plug in 5, take the square root of 5, and that gives you 2.4. All right, now we're going to do the sample standard deviation. And let's answer this question. The question is, what is one sample standard deviation from the mean? What we want to do is we want to know some distance on the right of the mean and on the left of the mean that is equal to one standard deviation on the right and one standard deviation to the left. But because it's on the left, we'll say minus one standard deviation. And we want to know where that distance is. Where is the distance? Where is it located at on this axis? So to do that, we have a formula that we can follow, and the formula is x bar plus or minus s. And let's write it out again, x bar plus or minus s, which tells me it's x bar plus s, that's the first formula, and x bar minus s, which is the next formula. And so let's plug it in. We know what x bar is, 4, plus s, which is 2.24. We add that, that's going to give us 6.24. And because it's two equations, we got to find also the other equation on the left. 4 take away 2.24, that's going to give me 1.76. All right, so what is that distance? 6.24 and 1.76, these are the distances that are from the mean. So let's draw the first one. And we start off here. Let's do that again. We start off at 6.24, somewhere around here. We start, and then we draw to the mean. That's one standard deviation, and we'll write it as 1s. While on the other side, 1.76, somewhere around here, that's where we're going to start, and we're going to draw it all the way towards the mean, because it's on the left side, it's negative one standard deviation. A little confusing, yes, but that is the convention. The convention is anything to the right of the mean is positive, anything to the left of the mean is negative. All right, let's do 2 sample standard deviations from the mean. In this case, our formula is going to change a bit because we're dealing with 2 sample standard deviations. So we're going to do that. Well, x bar is plus or minus 2s. So that's going to be pretty easy. So x bar plus or minus 2s is 4 plus 2 times 2.24, right? Do the math. We get 8.48. And also on the left side, 4 take away 2 times 2.24. That gives you negative 0.48. So let's draw the line now. The distance, 8.48 to the mean and negative 0.48 to the mean as well. So 8.48. It's around here somewhere, so the line's going to go that way. So let's draw that. So that's 2 standard deviations. And the next line, right? Negative 0.48. It's around here somewhere, and it's going to go that way. So let's draw that one. So from negative 0.48 all the way to the mean, that's negative 2 standard deviations. So here it is.